Hello YouTube, welcome to a new CineRetMe video. Waldorf has announced a new synthesizer and I'm in the communication with the developer. I'm here with Rolf, how are you?
Hi, how are you, Tom?
Good, I'm moving to a new apartment, but it's fine for me. Hope for you also?
No, I can stay luckily here where I am in my Frankfurt development office. You see in the back some PCBs, no, the other way, for new products and all kind of stuff.
You are from on the Waldorf side, you are the main developer of Waldorf, or how do you describe your task at Waldorf?
Well, they gave me the role of CTO, a little bit too big name, but I'm certainly the main developer of instruments like Quantum and the new one, which is called Iridium.
Mm-hmm. And you are working now some years already together. Or how long do you take to creating the Quantum? So when this project started?
So our initial collaboration, some people might remember, still being having my own company, was with the Nave iOS plugin. If I remember correctly, we released that 2013 maybe.
That's
a long time ago. So we started for this around 2011, and then we collaborated on a few other stuff, like a part of the EuroRack module. We make a plugin of Nave, and then I think it was around 2016 that we got the idea of doing a new big flagship instrument for Waldorf. And we showed it 2017 on the Frankfurt Music Fair, a first prototype. Then we showed it beginning of 2018 in January at the NAMM show in the US, the Quantum. And from there onwards, the instrument was sold. Then we announced beginning 2019 again on the NAMM show the 2.0 release with the kernel synthesis of Quantum. And at that time, after that time, I officially joined Waldorf as a member. And the first incarnations of the new Iridium was as early as 2018. So roughly, we have been working on the new Iridium for 2 years now.
Okay, so it takes a longer step than I thought it would be possible in 1 year because you have the engine, but then the hardware. So it takes 2 years for making it.
Well, there's we had already the engine, but remember we announced in 2019 beginning the new 2.0 kernel synthesis. And it took also almost a year for the final release. So this was running in parallel, and we also did some other stuff, which is not public now. So it took us on the timeline 2 years, but not in full-time development. And you have to see that beginning 2018, we were in the process of releasing Quantum. So also we were busy with bringing Quantum to the people, see the reactions, fixing bugs, enhancing with new features, workflow, not only the new synthesis. sampling stuff. We added quite a lot. And then we felt now it's time to have another member of the family which shares the same, let's say, platform or operating system. And so it was now time, beginning of 2020, to come out with the Iridium. And so we are very, very happy with this new product. And you can imagine that in times of Corona and all that kind of difficulties, it's not an easy step to come out with such a big thing. And but we made it. So here it is.
The name is a bit like it's Quantum and now Iridium. So it comes, where did you take the name of it? Or was it for you, I will name it Iridium because of something it was planned to, or it was a long thinking how to call it?
These name finding processes always in companies, as I saw it, very funny. Sometimes you fight a lot about it. And for example, for Quantum, we had many discussions, and the more beer you have at these discussions, the more fun this gets. And Quantum, and I cannot disclose the original name, originally had a different name than Quantum, but then we found out that some major brand had a similar name. So we moved away, and then we had another round and found Quantum. With Iridium, it was different. Axel Hartmann came up with a name, and it was immediately, intuitively for everybody clear, that's a great name for a synthesizer. And some people ask why we are not doing any more James Bond names, like the tradition of Waldorf. So Quantum is the first product not having a James Bond name, and for sure neither Kyra or Streichfett is a James Bond name. So here we are with Iridium, and I think it's a nice name.
I think you could it also make it very easy and name it Quantum Desktop, but you didn't.
Yeah, this is an interesting discussion. It's already getting discussed in several forums, and they're inventing new names for Iridium, which are funny to read sometimes. It's a little bit of a discussion. Is the glass half full or half empty? So how much is in the Iridium Quantum? And we could have call it Quantum Desktop or Quantum something. And then people will point out the differences between the Iridium and Quantum. And it's not a real Quantum because it does not have analog filters, because it has just digital filters. And so if we're now calling Iridium, people could say, well, why you're calling this Iridium, not Quantum XYZ? Because it shares lots of the engine of Quantum and it can exchange patches with Quantum. So what way you are doing it, some people will always have a point to do the other way around. So we feel that that was some feedback from some of the beta testers, that the difference of the filters and also some other more minor differences is big enough to say, well, it's a different thing. It's called Iridium. It shares the sound, same sound engine. People will quickly get that it shares the sound engine. But we are saying, well, it's Iridium and it has a slightly different sound to the filter. And we are not pretending to have the analog filter sound in Iridium. And I think we are giving it a slightly different character by this, and this is intentional. And I think it's good to have variation here.
So you doesn't emulate the analog filters from the Quantum, as I read from you, hear now from you?
Yes, not in a sense like many software plugins, let's say, trying to emulate famous analog compressor or EQ bit by bit, sample by sample, tiny frequency by tiny frequencies. We thought, well, there is a kind of a digital quantum mode in the filter section, which tries to come close to the quantum, but not to the extent to model every little analog detail. And some sounds will sound almost indistinguishable. And some other sounds, especially if they are, let's say, balancing quite high resonances, will sound a little bit different and you will have to die a little bit. That's one aspect. A second aspect is that the analog filters in the quantum are mono. So all the oscillators and the rest of quantum has a stereo audio path. But once you go through the mono filter, analog filters, it gets at that point summed left and right and merged, and which sometimes gives a good character, especially if you have stuff like granular things, if you want to have a little bit of melting in the sound. That's not the case in the Iridium. It preserves the stereo path. So we intentionally didn't want it to emulate the modification, let's say, of the analog filter in the Iridium. So you have the full stereo image. So some sounds will intentionally sound a little bit different. Still, you can dial in the oscillator sections. All stereo oscillators will have a kind of a stereo width parameter. So if you want to get the mono melting of grains or kernels, you can do it, but it needs an active intervention, let's say, by the user. And that's intentional. We wanted to give it a little bit different character in this sense.
So the patches, as you say, they are cross-compatible, so with the Quantum and Iridium, but if you change them or they sound different on each device.
Yes, some are quite identical, but some patches, let's say, from Richard Devine, where he does some complex stuff with filters and analog filters and resonances, then you have a little bit difference on the Iridium, and you may like even the different sound on the Iridium, or you may then adjust a little bit the filter stuff to get a similar experience on the quantum. But most of the sounds are same. As you mentioned, the patch format is essentially the same. They're directly compatible. And all the new digital filter modes of Iridium will get into the quantum. The quantum already has a simple digital mode from 2.0, but in the Iridium, we increased with new filter models. You can choose from a PPG, NAVE, LAGO, and your state variable model. You have high pass, band pass, all kind of stuff. And this will come to Quantum in a 3.0 update, and we will start that beta pretty soon.
Okay, and you think one of the biggest thing of the Iridium is of also it has 16 voices and not 8 voices.
Yes, since we do not have the analog filter, which somehow limitates the voice count in the Quantum, we have now 16 voices in the Iridium. Also, you can divide them into two layers. Although the Iridium has only one stereo out pair, the Quantum has another auxiliary out stereo output pair. So the question many users are asking now, will get the Quantum also 16 voices in digital filter mode, let's say? And that's something we are looking into it. It's not so easy as it sounds, because we have to make this switching between analog and digital modes quite seamlessly for the user. And it's technically also non-trivial, so we are working on this. And I cannot make any promise when it comes. So give me some time, but we think that would be an exciting feature also, of course, for the Quantum users, no question.
As talking about voices, could Iridium be used in future or already as a voice expansion for Quantum, or is it also something you think it could be possible in the future?
That's definitely something we are working on. It's nothing implemented in this regard yet, and but we see the opportunity to connect an Iridium to a Quantum and has Iridium then as a voice expansion, additional to sonic layers and all sort of stuff. So that's something we are definitely looking into it. But again, when we will have some functionality here, I cannot make a promise right now. So if you decide to buy an Iridium right now, be aware that nothing is implemented yet, but it's too exciting for us to have this feature, and maybe even also between two Iridiums and not only between Iridium and Quantum, and maybe between two Quantums. If somebody, I know a few people who have two, I know one guy who has even three of them. So that's an exciting feature, but again, disclaimer, nothing yet implemented. Look, in the last 2 years from the release of the Quantum, from the early version 1.2, I think we released with version 1.2.4 up with all the incarnation 2.0. We can all only say in the last 2 years we did a lot of work into the Quantum, and we will do the same for the Iridium and Quantum. And as they share the same platform, the same operating system we wrote, and the same sound engine, you can be assured that we have a lot of synergies between both platforms. So there's no concurrency between, no competition, let's say, between two siblings here. No, they will get the same love, and they will get participate from each other. And the more instruments we have on the platform, the more benefits everybody gets from it.
So the firmwares will be updated at the same time. So if something coming for Quantum, so it coming also for Iridium.
At the same time, in the sense, in the same minute or on the same day, I don't know, because it's still a different image. It's still a different technical build. But we are trying to keep this as close as possible.
And the difference is now between Quantum and Iridium, as you said, it's 16 voice. It has no analog filters.
Right.
And what is missing in the Iridium compared to Quantum? So no keys, of course, and a different interface?
So we have we are missing the second pair out of auxiliary outputs I already mentioned. We have the audio inputs, and we have a little bit of different layout. If we look here on the interface, we were in the situation to we wanted to get the same principle like in quantum, that one knob, one function. And we tried in a reduced panel space to have that as much as possible. On the other hand, we have now potentiometers and encoders much more closer together. That's something we had to do to get each oscillator section separate and the filter section. And but we have a reduced envelope and LFO section, and we do not have effects and the complex modulator controls on the panel. That's something everything available on the touch display with the encoders at the side. So we had to make some compromise here, and but we still believe that the Iridium, it's a tabletop machine, it's a desktop machine, and it's much more portable, of course, than the Quantum, so you can get it much more easier on stage for performances. And but still, we wanted to have this as a sound design machine too, so you can sit in front of the nice touch display with all the pots and encoder. That's a lot of fun in getting out of the box. There was another question, will there be an editor for it? No, we are doing this all this hardware stuff with all the panel elements to have an answer to all the people who want to get out of the box, out of the PC. Nothing against a good plugin. We are doing plugins ourselves, and there are other great plugins on the market. So it's good to have an option. And Iridium is another option, like Quantum, to get out of the box.
And the format is what people also can see. That it's quite similar to the Kira, yeah?
Or the Kira. Yes, the general shape and dimensions is identical to the Kira. And this is a shape which I think it's quite nice. It has a little bit of, I don't know the right word, bias, let's say, in the horizontal dimension. There will be rack ears possible for a 19-inch rack. But of course, it's a tabletop. And I also see people having the Kira, and that will be also true for Iridium, mounted like this. So there are mounting holes on the back side, on the bottom side, so you can mount it on this kind of standard plates and have it also somewhere nicely angled in front of you. So there are quite some options with the Iridium.
And the display is possible the same as on the Quantum, or is it big, is it smaller?
The physical dimensions are almost the same, so it's a kind of a 10-inch diagonal touch display. The pixel resolution is a little bit less, but not too much. And but we took great care in have a pixel perfect transformation of the Quantum UI to the a little bit less pixel space of the Iridium, that everything looks as sharp and as clear as on the Quantum.
Okay, and one difference also are the pads on the right side.
Right, and, yes.
And this is a quite big feature because it's not only for thinging, for drumming or something like this.
No, it's definitely is intentionally not for finger drumming. Please don't expect this to be a drum machine or some kind of finger drumming device. For this many, because for this there are many USB bus powered and similar controllers on the market, and since we have like in Quantum we have a USB Type A connector on the backside, like you have on your laptop or PC, you can directly connect any USB MIDI and of course also DIN MIDI controller, be it some kind of drum pad, MPC-like thing you can use. No, that's something you can do, and we will see probably many people are doing this. The pads on the Iridium are more for controlling a sequencer and arpeggio patterns. So you can latch arpeggio patterns based on notes and scales and chords. So there are three pitch modes for the pad matrix, and you can configure all the notes and scales and chords, and also save your own custom presets to it. And for the chords, you can work with inversions, splits, so they're kind of extensive things. And we added a new sequence mode, so the quantum started with a classic arpeggiator, which you can use here, and also a step sequencer, which you can also use here, and trigger from the pads. But we have now a kind of an XY trigger sequencer. That means that you step in the X or Y direction. There are different directional algorithms here through the matrix of 4x4 pads. And so you can set the chords or the notes, and you have some directions, including some random walks through it. And you can enable and disable pads, so you get more rhythmical patterns. So we had some new sequence modes here, which you may find similarly in some Eurorack modules. Mm-hmm. And we expect also here more evolution here, because this is the thing we started, and all our beta testers immediately loved that. And we have a long list of ideas, from chord generators, from more random stuff and generative stuff. And we invite also every user and owner to send us ideas. We want to extend these features. You still, of course, can live trigger notes and chords from these pads if you want. But also, to be clear here, they don't have aftertouch and velocity. They're just on off. So it's much more sequencing. However, there are some cinematic sounds in the quantum, and therefore also in the Iridium, where you just play a note and let the sound evolve. And this is something certainly in the ambient air you can do from the pads. And it's one of our best keyboard player within Waldorf. He felt immediately in love with this kind of pad sequencing, and he likes this really much, although he's the best talented player we have. So that's what it is.
The new matrix sequencer style, it reminds me a bit of René.
It doesn't have all the nice features of René, and we didn't want it to implement a René-like thing here. And on the other hand, René is a perfect CV and sequencer generator. On the other hand, we have a whole synthesis engine behind, and you can work with two layers and two different sequences at the same time on both layers. And so we certainly have had some inspiration from René, but it will go in a different direction due to the nature of the underlying sound engine. And that's okay. But coming to Eurorack, we shall mention that we have also some CV inputs on the backside.
This is something Quantum doesn't have, or?
No, so this is something where we see, well, the Quantum is a classic big flagship keyboard instrument, which of course you can place in front of Eurorack, but it's probably not the most typical use case for a big keyboard like this. But the tabletop instrument like Iridium fits nicely in front of some Eurorack's. However, it's not And you may think about all the sequence possibility. It's not so much meant as like a controller for the Eurorack stuff. You could use it via USB or DIN MIDI and then go into some kind of MIDI converter modules in the Eurorack. It's more the other way around. It's more an extension to your modular setup to have a nice granular engine, for example, which is polyphonic using multi-samples and has a nice touch displays. So we have 4 CV inputs going from plus minus 12 volt bipolar. You can individually scale them to 1 volt per octave and some other things. We have a gate in, and we have a start-stop in for the sequencing modes. And we have, and this is the only output, we have an input CV clock and an output CV clock. So okay. You can still use the sequencing stuff within Iridium and have a CV slave sequencer in your Eurorack, or you slave the Iridium to your Eurorack sequencer. So this goes both ways. So that's, I think, interesting feature to, let's say, expand the sonic capabilities with some experimental granular and sampling stuff, mm-hmm. if you want to.
And this new pet section on the right side, it has a complete new section in the menu, or how do you,
yes.
you implement and, it? Yeah.
Yes, and there will be also, of course, in the quantum. So if you build patches using the new trigger sequencers, let's say on the Iridium, load the same patch on the quantum. The quantum will have the ability to play these sequences and also edit this and change the sequences. Of course, the quantum does not have the pads, so in the quantum we will use the touch pads. So for example, if you go back on the screen, you see here on the so we have in the touch screen all the edit possibilities, and these will you find also in the quantum, that you have the same ability without the touchpads to play around with these features.
And this
for all this, the quantum, of course, needs an update. This will be in 3.0, and we are working on 3.0, and the beta will start soon.
So this will be for this year, this update for the quantum.
So we start the beta 3.0 soon. That means in a couple of days, but it won't have all the features of what. Part of the features of 3.0 will be stuff which I already mentioned. So the digital filter modes of the Iridium will be made available, and the trigger sequences. So the first drop of functionality in the beta will be that will be a public beta, like in 2.0, will be the digital filter modes. But there will be new features in 3.0 later on this year, which are not in the Iridium yet and are not in the quantum yet. And I cannot tell what it is, but people will love it. So, this will take some time, so I expect that the beta will take a few months.
Okay. And so Quantum Iridium has the same engine, granular, resonator, waveform, and a new kernel engine?
Correct.
Yeah. So there's nothing different. It's everything is the same, everything. So you yes. put a same engine in a smaller format, but reduce the analog filter, remove the analog filters, and raise the voices, yeah.
Raise the voices, and write.
Mm-hmm. And from the it looks amazing because it's far more compact, and it has a very compact interface to play around. The unit is finished, right? It's not in beta or it's not in development. It's finished, yeah.
So when today is June 12th at 2 p.m. The official announcement will be made, and I assume that many people looking this video, it's after 2 p.m. and the first units will be worldwide available. That's a big thing for Waldorf, especially in this time. We do not have too much quantities, of course. we are not Apple able to send out millions of devices in the world when the new iPhone release is, but we have devices available worldwide. Everybody has a chance. And we're working on the second production batch right now, then to fulfill all the pre-orders. And so we have really waited a bit to the point that we started production, and the production is running now, and from there we go.
Okay, that's a new step for Waldorf, because often we saw products and then they came out 1 year later.
Or never, like the Stromberg, but maybe we do it one day, the Stromberg, who knows? And that's a big step, and it's a lot of effort. And of course, it helped a little bit that it's based on the quantum platform. But on the other hand, all the production problems, like getting the case correctly made, having the paint color and the right thing, there are so many things in hardware production which could go wrong, especially in this time that you have every part available. It's produced in Germany, by the way. And so that was an advantage, of course, in these times. And but still, if some stupid part would not be available, then we couldn't have made it. So we made it, and it's a big effort, but I think it's the right way to do it. And from here we go.
Okay. There are some questions too I want to ask you for the end. The Iridium has 2 GB of internal ROM, right? Oh,
yeah, flash. It has the same memory configuration, basically, like the Quantum. I think it's even 2 point something. Please check the specs on the Waldorf website. It's the same like in the Quantum. We have the ability to use a USB drive to import and export new samples, and there are some feature requests which asking for streaming samples directly from a USB drive. And there are also some feature requests that you can connect the Iridium or Quantum directly to your PC or laptop and have all the sample space available as a virtual hard drive on your computer. So we are looking in all kind of stuff like this. And the good thing is, whenever we do a thing like this, which is more the basic functionality, we do it once, and all the instruments of the platform, currently Quantum and Iridium, will participate from that development. You can imagine that this kind of stuff we are going now with Quantum into really future out-of-the-box designs with an intuitive touch workflow. This is a lot of groundwork we have to do. We want to do it right. We do not want to have a new computer in a new box. We want to have a musical instruments in a nice body with nice controls. So we take our time to implement it. And be assured, we are continuing this journey, and more stuff to come.
Last question, or one of the last questions: MPE support is on the list, or because now yes. it invites the Iridium, because the Quantum it's a keyboard, which you have already the keys, but Iridium is desktop, so it invites now to get MPE support.
Right, we already started to look into the MPE. We are also, of course, looking into MIDI 2.0. Probably we will first still have MPE. The question could be also, why doing MPE if MIDI 2.0 is knocking on the door, let's say. But still, we believe there are so many MPE controllers now out that MPE is also a little bit more easy to be done. So that's something on our list. And of course, it makes even more sense to Iridium, but just as an information, Iridium and Quantum, of course, can receive polyphonic aftertouch. Okay. So all polyphonic aftertouch controllers can already work with Iridium and Quantum in that way. But of course, you want to have more dimension, which are in MPE, you get at least 2 more dimension than just polyphonic aftertouch. And that's something on our list, definitely.
Okay, and The price of it, because Quantum was around 4,000 euro or 3,900 or something like this. How much cheaper or how much is the price of the Iridium?
So that was another question. So when we bought out Quantum, we had somebody loved the big form factor with the keypad, and somebody said, "Well, I'm especially rearranging my studio setup to get the Quantum as a centerpiece." But some other people said, "Of course, I have already too much crowded space. I just wanted to have a module." So that was one aspect. Another aspect was to have increased voice count. And a third aspect was, well, could you have a little bit cheaper offering, or let's say more affordable offering? And maybe I would also do not need in this regard the analog filters if I have a cheaper price tag. And this is something the Iridium has. So you can check up the new price tag, but I assume that on street prices, we will have about half of the Iridium price for the Quantum. And we believe that's a quite affordable price for what you get. And but still, some people say, maybe ask Waldorf, would you have an even cheaper one, or do you still make even more affordable instruments for just a few hundred bucks? And this is something we always do, and we still do in the future. So we have currently the Streichfeld and the Ruckelt and the Blofeld. And we are working also in this category on new instruments, but we are in a small company. We cannot do it everything at the same time. So here is Iridium with half of the price tag roughly of the Quantum. And let's see what the future brings. We are in a quite good shape, have many ideas, have many things in the works. But I think the Iridium will attract many people, especially also from the price.
Okay. And power supply is probably the same or as the Quantum? So it's an external one?
No, the Quantum has an internal power supply. Which is, of course, what you want for such a big form factor. The Iridium is, of course, a smaller form factor, and we have an external supply, which is basically the same like we use for the Kyra. And but in these kind of tabletop setups, I think it's quite common to have all these external power supplies.
Okay, so the first units will be available today, so around 2,000 euro, 2,200 euro, roughly, if you...
Depending on all the taxing VAT situation worldwide, don't get me here too precise, because this is also eventually the dealer and the distributor determines. But roughly, you're getting in this range.
And so we can confirm it's not a hybrid synth, but a digital, all digital.
It's an all digital synth. There was some kind of fake website some people did, where this they were working, let's say, a little quick and a little lousy, put in the word hybrid, which was never used by Waldorf itself, because it's, of course, not a hybrid instrument. And now at 2 p.m. you have all the information on the Waldorf webpage. And feel free to write emails to Waldorf if you have additional, more detailed questions. Our support people are happy to help out. If we can answer something, we try to answer it.
More information about Iridium you get on waldorfmusic.com. Okay. Big thanks, Rolf, for this first look at the new Iridium. I wish good luck and that the people get their units quite fast.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Big thanks.
Yeah, big thanks.
Thank you. And I hope you enjoyed this video. Please let me know in the comments below what you think about the Iridium. And see you soon in our next Synanatomy videos. Bye.
Bye.